Today we're doing a tiny painting, about 8x8, of some kumquats. Kumquats are tiny oranges, and you eat them with the skin on because they can't peel them. And I've set up a light right beside my kumquats, which will cast a shadow in this direction. And I'm using a watercolor canvas, which I've never done before. This is going to be just as much of an experiment for me as it is you. And some watercolor pencils, some brushes, and some watercolors on a palette over here. So I'm just going to get started with my background. Well, apparently you can work wet on wet with these. So I'm just gonna soak my whole canvas here. How about that? Just soak your whole canvas with a mop. We'll do some wet on wet. Soak your whole canvas. And I'm going to use some orange in the background. How about that one there? And just paint right over the canvas. Now I want the lightest corner of the canvas to be the top right. So I'm going to fill in from the bottom left towards the top right, but I'm not going to fill in the top right completely. I'm going to leave it the way it is right now. Take some cadmium red and fill in from the bottom left. Okay, so we're gonna let that dry. But before we do, we're gonna lift the orange off the kumquats. Just take it back to the lines with a dry brush. Now I've drawn my composition on the canvas with a 2H pencil, and I'm just going to paint right over top of it. You always want a 2H pencil. You don't want to use anything darker than 2H with light lines, because it'll just show through your watercolor. Watercolors are meant to be transparent. You're supposed to be able to see the paint through your watercolor. See the canvas through your watercolor paint. Now we'll just let that dry. See, that's already starting to dry a little bit. Not too much, it's going to take a while. But I'm going to move on and do my shadows. Shadows are cast by this lamp here onto the white paper. You always want your still life to sit on white paper to cast the shadows. Then you can see the tones really well. So taking a burnt sienna pencil, I'm just going to draw in my lines of the shadow, darkest shadow. Now, interestingly enough, I have my Home Depot towel, and it's orange. The Home Depot orange is a patented color, and nobody else can use it. Patented colors are a closely guarded secret, like Tiffany blue or UPS brown, or Home Depot yellow, or Home Depot orange. Closely guarded secrets. How they arrive at those colors, people don't talk about. Because they say Tiffany blue, they want that color to themselves. So I'm just very lightly drawing in my shadows. For the third degree shadow, I have a burnt red. And then I have a red. I'm just going to take a round brush and soak in those shadows. Now those colors, those yellows, are starting to dry already. So are the oranges in the background. The red is your shadow. Red, brown. But you see in a painting, there's always a thin band of shadow right at the base of the bowl and just under the kumquats. And we're going to fill that in with a darker brown. A darker brown directly onto the canvas. The canvas is wet, so it'll just soak right in. Pencil crayon will soak right into the canvas. See, that is drying quite readily, quite quickly, as opposed to a piece of paper. The canvas is soaking up the pigment. So now we're going to take a black. Sharpen it up. We're going to draw this negative space in between the kumquats. So just start filling in underneath the shadows in the kumquat bowl. Now with the pencil crayons, you're basically just building up layers of paint, layers of pigment. That we'll touch up with a brush later. Now we need an orange. Here we go. Yeah. Let's just put some orange into these. So take your round brush and try and push back this black. We'll just let that dry for now. That won't take long to dry. Take some black, just go over a shadow, the darkest part of the shadow. See, we're just building up layers of pigment with the watercolor pencils. These watercolor pencils are from Denmark, I believe, or Holland, and they're very light. So you have to build up the pigments. Yeah, I think they're from Holland. See how we're getting degrees of shadow now? So you can remove paint just as much as you can put it on. All you'd have to do is push against it and you'll remove paint. Looking pretty sharp so far. So I am going to take some orange. Let me get a tube of orange. You always want to keep your tubes in an airtight container. That'll make your tubes of paint last for years. So they'll dry out pretty quick in a couple years if you don't otherwise. So just keep them in an airtight container. Now I have a cadmium yellow and a cadmium red, and I'm going to mix my own orange. Get a smaller brush here. There we go. You always want to keep your brushes clean. Clean brushes will last you a long time, as opposed to ones that you don't take care of very well. They won't last you at all. Cadmium is a beautiful bright color. It's very warm in intensity, so it has a high chroma. And it's a lot of it is the good stuff. The expensive stuff is toxic, it's a carcinogen. But unless you're putting your brushes in your mouth or eating paint, you should be okay, but you have to use it in a well-ventilated studio anyway. You don't want to breathe in fresh fumes from the paint. This is what we've got so far. I'll show it to you. And we're just building up layers of pigment. This is what we've got so far. So now we're going to touch up the shadow again and just build it up. I'm going to use a dark brown this time, sharpen it. Now my third degree shadow is pretty much done, but the intermediate shadow, the red, has to be just a little bit darker. That's good. Now there comes a point in watercolor when you're adding layers that you're just pretty much removing paint. And we don't want to do that. We want to keep our pigment as thick as possible while still being transparent. So I'm just going to add some here. Like so. And that'll soak right into the pigment. Because the canvas is wet, That'll soak right in. Good. Now we're going to do the bowl. And the bowl is going to be orange as well. So let's take some orange. And do the darkest part of the bowl. There we go. That's your bowl. Now we just have to finish off the kumquats. So I'm going to take a yellow, cadmium yellow. Now those are your kumquats. I'm just going to add some black in between the empty spaces. Now I'm going to take some green, sharpen my pencil. I'm going to draw in the green stems. That's good, and I'll just hit those with a little bit of water. I forgot one here. It's brown. No, it's green. And one here. And that, my friends, is a very impressionistic painting of kumquats. I'm going to take a 2H pencil. I'm going to sign it right up here. Now, that is a finished painting. Very impressionistic, very blurry. Impressionism is blurry, and post-impressionism is super blurry. So I'm just going to grab my camera here. I'm going to show you what I have. These are my kumquats. And see how the shadow is cast by the lamp that's beside to the right of the kumquat bowl? That is my shadow in my painting. Thank you very much. Have a nice night.